1012, just smack home. Testing 1 2 1 2, testing 1 2 1 2, test mic 1 2 1 2. Okay, good day. I'm Louis de Los Angeles, now investing in Philippines.com, and today I'll be discussing to you one of the seminars, the talk I gave with the latest My Sense, My Future, My Money. My money and future, and I'll be discussing to you about my finances as my responsibility. Of course, I'm breaking down my talk to 4 parts. Una, yung bad financial mentality, and second will be the savings the right way, and third is the spending habits, the good and the bad. And third is we'll be discussing about true wealth. How do you define wealth will help you achieve it? Okay, our first topic is bad financial mentality. We'll be discussing about four bad mentality that we Pinoys have toward money. Okay, first one is Pinoy think is saving as tira-tira. Okay. Usually, it's the common belief that people save only the leftovers. So, why do we do that? Because sometimes, ang mga Pinoy kasi is, what we do is we have a limited income, and small income is that, and we think and we have this malaking expenses in front of us, that's why we don't bother to save anymore. So, now, mas nauna tayong kumastos, then whatever is left, yun lang ang ating dalpira. So it's not consistent, and in the back of our mind, our expenses are more important. That's why at times, hindi na natin nagagawang mag-save, dahil sabi natin hindi na sakto, yung hindi na aabot yung ating income to cover our expenses. Thus, most of the times, as yung savings is considered as whatever is left after spending things, after paying your debts, after buying your luho, yung mga wants nyo, and sometimes it's not even enough. That's why it's been a common practice for us, and it's a bad financial mentality for us. Sana nga po is important natin to, and I'll discuss some more later regarding this tira-tira. Second is, we have this bad mentality to blame others instead of taking the responsibility for our finances. That's why the phrase is, yung sabi natin is, I am poor because, mostly will say because my parents are poor. Others will blame it because our government is corrupt. Minsan sabi nila is, hindi nag-match ang aking profession sa aking trabaho. And the bad thing is, most of the time they blame other people instead of taking the responsibility for their finances. And it's a bad mentality because if you put the blame on others, you're giving those people or consciences or situation control over you instead of you controlling your finances. So it must be noted that we must avoid this kind of mentality, the blame mentality. Sabi nga is, ito yung pinakaunang kasalanan ni Adan at ni Eva. When God asked bakit kinagat ni Adan yung pinagbabawal na prutas sa paradise, ito sinabi niya kay God, binling niya si God, sabi niya si, ikaw yung ginawa mo na babae. Then when God asked yung Eva, sabi daw ni Eva is, tinuro niya yung ahas, sinabihan ako ng ahas. Then the ahas, since it's just ahas, it's actually used, as the story says, it's used by the devil, and he has nothing to do. He has no answer because he's the last one. So, sabi nga natin, namana natin sa ating mga first parents ang pag-point ganun daw, pag-point. Pag pinoint mo daw, isa, four fingers are pointing back at you. So, before blaming others, take responsibility for our finances. It's important that you take control of your finances. Nobody else can make a change for your finances except you. Dahil ikaw may hawak nito. One bad financial mentality is, I got to have that too. Ay yung airingit mo, pag may nakita tayong iba na may bagong 42-inch TV, usually kapitbahay, probably, or somebody in our class or in a workplace na may bagong phone, sabihin, in the back of our mind, kaya tayo napapa-spend sometimes, kailangan ko rin ganun, which is actually envy. Kaya we avoid that as much as possible because it's bad, because it doesn't allow you to be in control of your finances. It forces you to spend without any preparation or any budget for it. That's why it's a bad mentality. And the last one I will talk about is mentality is, I deserve this mentality. Yung ubus biyaya. Yung sabihin mo, karapatan ko to dahil pinaghirapan ko to, sweldo ko to. That's why people, mostly in the working class, middle classes, they tend to go to vacations, gastos ng maraming pera, airline ticket, hotels, on a 3-day weekend or sometimes, because they say they deserve it. Dahil stress sila and they have to go out. And sometimes, hindi nila namamalayan na napapagastos pa sila. So, the problem is, every time, sweldo, which usually is 15-30, naubos yun. So, some people do go, especially it's Friday, they go out, they go partying, say to relax, sometimes to go to eat at the best resto, an expensive resto, para lang satisfy nila ang sarili nila na they deserve this and they gotta have it. Kasi sila, pinaghirapan nila to sa kahit ay kanilang pera. Pero it's okay, but the problem is, inuubos nila yung lahat-lahat ng expenses on one day instead of savings. That's why the more they get into debt dahil yung kanilang kinita ay hindi sapat para isatisfy yung gusto nilang nasabi nang deserve nila. So later I will talk about something about this and we'll discuss this to you in a while. Okay, savings the right way. So how do we save the right way? Sabi ko kanina is Pinoy have this definition of tira-tira, which is been a bad practice kasi nga, instead of making a savings, at the end of the day, wala talagang save ang Pilipino. Dahil, una is, we have so many wants, and then they're not budgeting their needs. And that's why, kung ano man ang matira, yun na nag-save nila. And oftentimes, walang natitira. So, this is because of the wrong formula of the savings. Ang alam natin is, savings is equal to income less expenses. So how do we correct that? We have to have a new formula for our savings, which is income less savings is equal to expenses. Ano ibig sabihin nun? If you look at the formula, income less savings or expenses, it means we have to save first, then whatever is natira is actually yun ang ating pag-expenan. Yun ang ating gagastusin. That's our budget. That's our limit. So dapat hindi tayo sasobra dun sa ating expenses kasi savings gets first, it's a specific amount. Then whatever is left, yun ang magiging i-stretch mo to cover all your budget. So, another way to save right is to taking notes of your expenses, that is tracking and learning from it. Dahil most people don't save because they think they are saving, but actually not. So the best way is to track your expenses. Tracking your expenses is either by keeping yung resibo ng mga binili, writing it down in a piece of notebook, small notebook, making a spreadsheet to monitor it. And from there you can learn which expenses are you overexpending, which expenses are unnecessary, and which expenses are actually what's wrong. From there you can weed it out and have a better savings at the end of the day. Dahil when you know what you're spending at, alam mo kung ano ba yung wants, needs. Those are the most important things you want. People don't just easily segregate that because when you're out there and it's an immediate need or something, but actually it's a want, mapapagastos ka. Kasi nandun ka na, hindi mo na maaari. But if you have a back of your mind idea kung ano mga yun, magkakaroon ng parang barrier to remind yourself that this is not a need, it's a want. That's why you need to take notes of your expenses. And again, I said it's either you keep the receipts of your purchases, writing it down, probably in your iPhone or your cell phone, if you have a note-taking app or in a small notebook, piece of paper, anything. And at the end of the day, you collect that and then you look at it. And makikita mo kung gano'ng karami ang pinag-spinan mo na usually unnecessary at the end of the day. And from there, you will learn, you will try to cut down those expenses and you'll have a control over it. People are tend to not to budget because mayroong budget pa hindi nasusunod. That's why budgeting is, it's the aim of budgeting is to lower expenses, increase savings once more. Hindi pwede naman basang mag-save ka ng isang bagsakan. Saving is the discipline. Help, you must be able to discipline yourself, set aside amount of money before spending. So your budgeting will help you in that. When you know that you're going to spend only, you can only accommodate this amount, you will actually control your spending. That's why, again, I said you need to take notes so that you know where you're spending, and when you're able to understand your spending habit, you can be able to form a budget, which will you base your spending habits. Then, we have these bad spending habits. Ano mga to? I cannot give everything, but I have some examples of bad spending habits. First one is yung, yan nga, nabi ko is nanggit buying. When you see somebody else who have new gadgets, latest clothes, bagong forma, it's easy to be envious. And thus, you too will gonna buy. So, as much as possible, avoid being envious to your neighbor. Set your own standards. Hindi porket yung nakita mo yung kaklase mo, co-worker mo, bagong phone, is babayad, is mag- isip ka ng bumili, and then it will eventually force you to buy even you are out of budget or maybe wala ka ng pera. So don't ever buy something when you're just envious of other people. Second is the pasikat buying. Sometimes we buy out of being too showy. Sometimes gusto nating maging in or the hit, yung nauna na mayroong iPhone, nauna na may bagong phone shirt, nauna na may ganitong klaseng clothes, or nauna na may ganitong klaseng gadget sa house. We are most of the time is pasikat. Gusto nating pakita na I can afford this, or I'm better than you, or I'm great. Kaya nga, we buy things kasi, sabi nga nila is, we buy things to impress people we don't even like, and we don't even know. So, important is, don't buy things that tend to be because of this reason. Hindi ka bibili ng bagay dahil gusto mo pasikat. Bibili ka ng bagay dahil kailangan mo. It's a need. So, avoid spending because of your pasikat mentality and spending habit. Next one is, the sale kasi iba yun. It's oftentimes the most catchy thing in malls, in online stores, having a sale. Sale kasi, so madaling bumili pag sale. Most of the time people think that kasamura sila sa sale, but actually if you observe malls, prices are actually started low maybe a month or 2 months ago, and the prices is going up and up and up until malapit yung sale. Maybe a week or two is so high, then you will say on the sale day it's 50%, but if you compare it, most of the time the sales price on this day is actually the same price 2 months or 3 months ago when hindi pa siya hit, when hindi pa siya sikat na product. That's why people think it's nakamura, but actually it was the same price before, or probably it was just a product na mas lower ang quality, and people think they're getting the right one. So be careful when buying on sale. There are things that you can buy on sale which are a good buy, so always make that choice. But don't buy too many. Sometimes bumibili ka ng madami kasi sale. So example is, instead na ang ginagamit niyo sa isang week na tissue ay isang bundle lang, napapabili ka ng 10-4 dahil naka-sale nga. And actually, you don't need those, all those, and you're just spending more than what your budget is, kaya nasisira ang budget. And the last bad spending habit is, I know you know all of this, and it's one of the worst reason why nababawasan mo ang utang. Dahil utang para makabili. This is a bad habit. Either you use a credit card or you make pagibig loan, this is low, which is common to most workers. The workforce. Again, avoid buying on credit if it's not necessary. Avoid using your credit card. Kaskas doon, kaskas dito when it's not necessary. If it's a need, then we can make sure that it's within the budget and you can cover it. But if it's just a want, don't ever buy on credit. Because the more it will bury you in debt. Mas marami kang utang tuloy kasi it's patong-patong. So if it's something that's want lang, don't buy and charge it with a credit card or get a loan just to get it. Make sure to have a control over that. Next is, siyempre may bad, then there's a good spending. So what are good spending habits? Like I said, buy. You have to buy for quality, then the quantity, and the price. You have that kind of standard. You must set a standard when making a purchase. So buy things that are of good quality because they are worth their value for it. If it's good quality, then quantity will be good. If it can give you a good quality at number of this quantity, it's better. And then the last choice is price. You must make sure that the price is affordable, it's right, the value says it right, and it's the right thing that you need. Then, okay, buy your needs and not your wants. Very simple thing, you have to ask yourself, mamamatay ba ako pag di ko to nabili? That's the most important reason. Needs are the things that you need to exist to live, while wants are just luho. So instead of buying your luho, make sure that wants comes and needs comes first. Needs comes first. Wants can be bought on a later date, kung nakakalawa ka na. So always make sure to buy needs first, not your wants. Third one is to stick to your budget and don't buy if not within the budget. Sometimes madaling i-break yung budget mo because it's so tempting to buy. But make sure and always remember that once you break that budget, it will be a domino effect. Maapektuhan yung budget mo for this month, or the next month, and the other succeeding months. Kasi nga, there's a break that you made. So make sure to stick to your budget. If hindi kaya, huwag pilitin, huwag bibili. Make sure that you have control over your budget and make sure that you follow that religiously. And lastly, when making purchases, make sure that you can compare or have an alternative in buying. And make sure that whatever you compare, it's worth the price. Maaaring mayroong brand A, brand B, and brand A says this is 30 pesos but only one, but you can do this and buying brand B, which is half the price but can only clean half of what you can. So if you do it, you're just going to be spending more if you can use buy B. Kasi mura, but it doesn't really have the quality as what B. So quality, then quantity and price. So make that alternative, choose wisely, make sure that you get the best quality first, then the quantity and price, and based on those two alternatives you're choosing from. And true wealth, how you define wealth will help you achieve it. Defining mayaman, what is mayaman? Mostly we'll say mayaman means maraming pera. Others will say yung maraming kotse. Again, but actually, defining wealth is mayaman is actually will help us define our financial freedom. So, for me, the financial freedom or being rich or wealthy means a state of financial stableness. Maaring mayaman ka nga, hindi ka naman stable. Marami kang iniisip, marami kang pinagkakaabalahan, maraming gumugulo sa isip mo. So, I don't think that will be a financial stableness. You're not free. You're not financially free dahil because of that money you have, marami parang gumugulo sa isip mo. So for me, is financial freedom is having that state of financial stableness. That means is hindi ka nag-alala kung saan pupunin pagkain mo ngayon, tomorrow, next day, next month because you know you have something. You're prepared for everything. You have your budget. You have your source of income that will come. Then, How do we achieve financial freedom? One is having a saving habit. No matter how small or big, you have to start, you have to have a saving habit. Again, I will reiterate, the formula for a good saving is income less savings is expenses. Always have that in mind, and that's one way to be achieve financial freedom. Second is to set aside emergency funds. So aside from savings that you have, your savings could be for savings for your retirement, savings for the education of your children, and savings for small business you want to start. You also have to have set aside an emergency fund. Emergency funds are there to be able to provide in case of emergencies, having an emergency fund. Or if able you lost your job, at least you have a 6 months of emergency fund equivalent to your salary to cover for those months that you will only be employed. Probably enough to cover kung may nagkasakit sa pamilya, hospital, and hindi kaya cover lahat ng health card ng company or any other insurance which you have. Or probably a typhoon or sudden calamity that destroyed everything. So you need something to start over. So you have to have this emergency fund aside from your savings fund. Then to achieve financial freedom, you must enlarge your mental wallet. So what's your mental wallet? Mental wallet is your capacity to hold money. Because sometimes people are afraid when they're holding a lot of money. And when they are afraid with that amount of money, what happens is they tend to spend it. Because they think that spending it, buying this or that, will actually be better than having this amount of money. So one of the exercises I've been hearing about is how much amount of money have you put in your wallet and carried it over. Maybe you put 1,000 in your wallet, then you walk to the mall, you went here and there, and it's nothing because it's small. But at the back of your mind, it's comfortable. What if you put 10,000 in your wallet and go to the mall, go to the ride the tricycle? Of course, you probably in the back of your mind, you'll be kind of afraid, cautious, because you might use it. Somebody might mayroong duhutang ka ng wallet mo, or malaglag mo, or magbigay mo yung amount kasi 10,000. If you pull it, something might drop. Or if nakita ng tricycle driver is kikidnapin ka, tinubuhin sa'yo. So having that consciousness behind is also hinders you to actually hold the money and save it. Kasi because instead of saving it or something like that, nas napoforce ka na spend it to buy it into a tangible item na hindi naman ako kaya. So mostly, if people receive their bonus, they tend to buy the gadget that they want instead of saving it. Dahil hindi nila kayang i-hold yung 10,000 or any amount of bonus na malaki. Or sometimes, when people get an extra income or they get an extra raise, what they do is they improve their houses. They repaint it, they buy new furnitures kasi akala nila they'll be translating that money, the additional money, into something that's tangible and strong, but in actuality not. Kasi once they use that money to buy these things, it's not anymore money. It's something that's in use already then, and you can't recover it anymore. So enlarging your mental wallet means enlarging your capacity to hold a bigger sum of money and save it and make use of it and able to hold that to make better use of it, like putting an investment that will give back money, will earn income, or putting it in an emergency fund for the future, or putting it in an investment vehicle that will be of use in the future. So with that one, again, investing in income, saving habit, with the saving habit, with the large capacity to hold or money, you will be able to have lots of savings. And with that comes, you must be able to save and invest in income generating investment. Saving money and putting it in the bank for safety is good, but even extra money and still sitting there, then sayang naman pag hindi siya mag-earn ng income. So better put it in an income generating investment vehicle, which is could be a stock market, yeah? Bonds, which give better black, will give you a better return, or a special arrangement for a business with somebody who can give you a return in a cash flow for the meantime. And also, the last thing is you have to enjoy your income. Kasi pinaghirapan mo yan. But you have to enjoy it in the kurut way. Kurut meaning small, a pinch. It means that when you buy something, the amount of that thing, which is probably one only or luho, is just a small piece of what you're actually earning or saving. It means it doesn't matter if you buy. So, if, for example, if you're only earning 10,000 a month and you want to buy an iPhone which is around 32,000, 24,000, then that's not a kurot. But what if you're earning a total earnings coming from your employment, your salary, your small business, your brackets is around 200,000 in a month. So buying 32,000 is okay. You could consider it kurot. Or probably you want to spend dinner sometimes. Gusto mo kumain sa labas, some expensive restaurant. Treat mo pa yung mahal mo, yung mga anak mo, and you'll probably spend 2,000 pesos. And you're earning actually 110,000, 210,000 pesos. So it's just a small amount. It's a kurot. So you get to spend to enjoy your income when what that enjoyment, the amount you will spend is just a small pinch. It means you have the, it has an extra, it's a bit. So don't be in a hurry to enjoy things when still your earning capacity is too small. But once it gets bigger and it allows you to save, to set aside emergency fund, and it allows you to invest in income generating investments, then it's the good time for you to enjoy your savings, because you're enjoying all those things are more than what you're earning now, and they are insignificant to consider. So if ever it comes to you to need to enjoy, make sure it's just a pinch of it. If ever hindi pa ganun kalaki, enjoy the small things in life, like ice cream cone kung mabibili lang sa tabi-tabi with your pumpkins and nuts, or a small cake you can buy going home. Usually 100 to 200 pesos ang cake lang. Phone, probably not now, but you can start saving for it. Okay, so thank you for listening to my small talk, and I wish you all to have achieved financial freedom. And do check or read my blog, it's investingphilippines.com. Also join financial forums online, like in Facebook, and one I'm personally in is the Filipino Financial Freedom Forum, the FFMF, the Global Filipino Investors, and there are some other there. Also read the business section of the newspaper and watch business news like NC On The Money, CNBC, and Maypuhunan, etc. This will be of help to you in making and taking care of your finances. And as usual, as a parting word do something small today towards achieving your goal. So it doesn't have to be big, it doesn't have to be a big savings right now, but starting small, pwedeng piso-piso ang savings today, then the next day it will grow 2 pesos, the next week 5 pesos. Small things when done consistently and religiously actually grows, accumulates. So again, thank you for listening, and again, this is Louis from investinginphilippines.com. Always take care, and your finances is your responsibility. Thank you.